church today, we'd be appreciative if you could help us put away the craft stuff or whatever. I'll be downstairs to tell you where what goes, and Joyce will be up in the balcony telling you where to put things up there. So it won't take, it shouldn't take that long. We have enough people. We'll take them, bring it up the lift, make an assembly line or whatever. And then there's things downstairs that need to stay downstairs. And I'll be there and I'll tell you where to put things. Okay, thank you.
Yes, Joyce?
Yes, being that it is the season of Advent, Christmas is soon upon us, the Caring Ministry will be sending out some Christmas cards to the people that we know and have addresses for already. If you have anyone that you would like to have them receive one of the Christmas cards, please give me your name and address, and I will make sure that it gets out the mail to them. Okay, thank you.
This coming Wednesday, it will be a Bible study at High Church at 6 p.m. So this is the day the Lord has made. So we gather together and march to God. So I invite you to stand. We might join together in our call to worship, which is responsible. The time is coming when the Lord shall pour his most special blessing on the earth.
Watch and pray ready for that time. What should we do?
Be vigilant. Keep your hearts, minds, and spirits open to God's word.
Help us, O Lord, to be aware of all your blessings.
Come, let us celebrate God's love for us.
Make our hearts ready to receive your gift of love, O Lord. Amen.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
We are glad whether we drove in or climbed up, whether we logged on or tuned in. We are glad to be here in this community with this family. It is a place of joyful hope, of radical welcome. It is a place where together we can wait in wondrous anticipation of the kingdom to come.
Many people shall come to say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of God, to the God of Jacob, that God may teach us God's ways, and that we may walk in God's paths.
We light this candle as a sign of our hope, our joyous hope that we can be restored, our faith restored, our strength restored, our confidence restored, our joy restored, as we watch and wait with all God's people for the promise to be fulfilled.
There's so many hymns. There is a voice in the wilderness crying. You can find the word in the future. It's time by Jesus.
Thank you.
sing. Now let's join our hearts in the spirit of confession. Lord of all time, we come into your presence asking your forgiveness. We have failed to live as people of the present. We have wasted our moments, wanting the future now. These are our dreams as the answer to today's problems. Grant us seeing your blessing in each day. We have looked backward to glory days, that seem glorious only in their passing. Open our eyes to our mission at hand. Open our ears to your message to us today, that we might share and bring the good news for your salvation to the world. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Let us continue our silent prayers this morning. Christ has paid the price for your sin, because he sought your presence in the house of God. When we confess our sin, we no longer have to fear the throne of judgment. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Amen. And let us pray together the prayer that Jesus has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and glory forever. Amen. And as we continue, please join me to pray for illumination. O Lord, your word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Give us grace to receive your truth in faith and love, and strength to follow the path you set before us. Through Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good morning. Our scripture reading today comes from the Gospel of Matthew, so please stand if that's comfortable to do. I will be reading from chapter 5, verses will be coming familiar with this time here, reading 1 through 9. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may stay. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today?
Good.
So how was your Thanksgiving day? So did you already eat turkey?
Yes.
And today is the Sunday after Thanksgiving, which is the first is a season of waiting and preparing for Jesus Christ's coming into our lives. And as you saw, we just lit up our first Advent candle today. But we are doing our sermon series about Beatitudes, faith, faith, and I hope maybe next Sunday you may remember, you may memorize this Beatitudes. So we do follow lectionary readings, but even though I can preach about sermon from our lectionary readings, I will check about these Advent readings. So I opened the lectionary readings, and I found out that one of the lectionary readings was the text that I chose for today's sermon, Isaiah chapter 2. And the theme, and the whole lectionary theme, is about peace. So I didn't intend it, but I believe this is the word that God is giving us today. For the people are waiting and preparing Jesus Christ's coming. In today's reading, Jesus says, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." So what is the peace that Jesus is talking about? And how can we become peacemakers? And according to the Oxford Languages Dictionary, peace is freedom from disturbance, tranquility, or a state or period in which there is no war, or a war has ended. And a peacemaker is a person who brings about peace, especially by reconciling adversaries. However, these meanings of peace and peacemaker are different from the peace that Jesus talks about today. This peace that Jesus is talking about is the peace of God, which surpasses all our understandings. That is not just freedom from disturbance or a state in which there is no war. And we are seeing what is happening right now in Ukraine. There was no war in Ukraine 1 year ago, right? But now, so many people are dying and suffering because of this war. So there is no perfect peace in this world. So how can we become peacemakers in this world? How can we deliver and spread the peace of God to others? Is that even possible? But in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 to 7, Paul says, I know the reader has read when we had the Thanksgiving service, right? Same reading. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your heart and your minds in Christ Jesus. So peacemakers are people who guard their hearts and minds with the peace of God. So when we say about peace, we should be filled with God's peace first. So why do people fight? Why do people make a war? Because in most cases, they are anxious. They feel the crisis, and they think war is their last and best option. But peacemakers are the people who guard and protect their minds and heart from any other anxiety and worry. They are people who ask for God's peace through consistent prayer, supplication, and thanksgiving. And they are people who are ready to receive the peace of God. So prayer and thanksgiving are essential for being a peacemaker. And peacemakers are people who reconcile with others through the peace of God. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 18 to 19 says, all of these new things are from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and who gave us the ministry of reconciliation. In other words, God was reconciling the world to himself through Christ, by not counting people's sins against them. He has trusted us with this message of reconciliation. So our peacemaking and reconciliation begin with reconciliation with God. God reconciled us through Jesus Christ, who gave himself up for us. And Jesus Christ came to this world for the reconciliation between God and us. And through Jesus Christ, our broken relationship was recovered. And he gave us the ministry and mission of reconciliation in this world. So peacemaker's job is doing a ministry of reconciliation. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 23-24, Jesus says, so when you are offering your gift at the altar, if you remember that your brother or sister has something against you, leave your gift there before the altar and go. First be reconciled to your brother or sister, and then come and offer your gift. So here Jesus says that you are forgiven, and my sacrifice recovered your broken relationship with God. Then you should go and do the ministry of reconciliation. And that starts with your relationship with your family, your friends, your brothers and sisters. Before worshiping God, coming to church and giving an offering and serving God, you should consider your relationship with others. And if you love God, and if you believe you are forgiven, you should love and forgive others. You should make peace and reconcile with your sisters and brothers. And when I was in the army, I was in the choir and praise team at the church I was attending. So every Sunday morning, I iron out my combat dress uniform and put a good shine on my boots to be ready to go to church. And one Sunday, when I was polishing my boots, one of my colleagues was teasing me and asked, so why do you always wear a good quality uniform and boots on Sunday? You look like a hypocrite. He was kidding, he was teasing me, but I was upset, really upset when I heard that. So I had a little trouble with him, and I went to church. But when I was leading the praise team, I was playing guitar and making a service, and listening to the pastor's sermon, my heart felt uncomfortable the whole time, the whole service. My colleagues' words were ringing in my mind, and it really bothered me. I couldn't pay attention to the worship service. It was because his word hit the nail on the head. It was not about the clothes and shoes, but about my heart, about worship. It was about my daily life and worship as a Christian and a follower of Jesus Christ. So when I returned from the church, I bought coffee for him and gave it to him and apologized for the quarter in the morning. So worshiping And serving God does not just happen in a church building. Our whole life is our worship. And God wants to worship God in our daily life by reconciling with others, spreading the peace of God to them. And people would know about God and God's peace through our life. Do not think of this worship service in your daily life separately. Our life is worship. And be peacemakers and reconcile with others and forgive them with God's love. And peacemakers are people who change the community to which they belong. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 4, the prophet Isaiah prophesies that God will judge between the nations and settle the disputes of mighty nations. Then they will beat their swords into iron plows and their spears into pruning tools. Nation will not take up sword against nation. They will no longer learn how to make war. So in this text, we can also see God's peace that settles every dispute and ends every war in the world. And this is not a temporary and contractual peace, but it is a perfect peace that changes our swords into plowshares. It is a peace that transforms our weapons that destroy and kill people into tools that build the community and rescue people. This is the peace of God that is not just making a truce and maintaining combat readiness, but it is a totally different movement of creating a world where people can live together. And if we are children of God, we should deliver this peace of God to the world, to our community. We should participate in this peace project of God. So how can we participate in this project? How can we become peacemaker? This peace of God should be fulfilled in our church and community. This Jesus word about peacemaking is very practical teaching. So we should ask ourselves, am I a relationship builder or am I a relationship breaker? Or meditating on a conflict? Or am I creating a conflict? Does our church embrace others and do ministry of reconciliation? And are we praying and trying to build our church as a peacemaker church? And yes, this is never easy. However, you should remember why Jesus came to this world and died on the cross. He suffered and died to reconcile us with God. And he sends us today as peacemakers, as children of peace, who build a broken relationship, who mediate a conflict, who build a peaceful community. And Jesus wants to start a journey of peacemaking from our church and our community. And if we cannot love and reconcile with our brothers and sisters in Christ, how can we love and spread the peace of God in the world? And how can people see us as children of God if we are fighting and making a conflict? And how can we become peacemakers? And that is not easy, yes. But following Jesus is entering the narrow gate. It is challenging and hard. remember that God allowed us, our brothers and sisters, to pass that narrow gate. We should work together. And God called us together and sends us into our community in the world today. And Jesus says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Let us pray. God of peace, you are gracious, you are merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. You call us your children, you send us to our community as peacemakers. Forgive us, Lord, we tend to forget our role as peacemakers in our family, in our church, and community. And teach us and lead us today to be a church to spread your peace to the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. This time I invite you to stand as able. And we sing our next one. Come thou longest happy Jesus. In our hymnal page number 196.
To have dialysis for the rest of his life, but He is out of danger. There's no gangrene. It looks like, he keeps taking care of his health, eating the right food, and getting his medical attention. He's going to be all right. And as he's my younger brother, it's really important to me. So I thank you. We can take him off the prayer list now. But now and then, if you just remember my brother Gil, and if you're a golfing person, you may know the name Gil Hance, because his son is a very famous golf course designer.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Say a prayer for my sister, Linda, and I'll ask the same operations come Friday.
Thank you.
Your sister.
In the NICU.
In
the NICU at Albany Med.
Albany Med. So we will send this to Albany Med. So thank you so much for the prayer ministry team. Today is all of this. There's so many things for this, with your care and prayer about. So they receive the babies, they receive. And experience God's love through your ministry. So let us pray. God of love and comfort, we gather together to celebrate one of the ministries of our church. We give thanks for the opportunity out of love and out of concern for our Christian brothers and sisters to share a tender gift to those in need, especially newborn babies in the hospital. While we know that you're always present in our lives, and your love transcends all tragedy, illness, and pain, we also know that sometimes a physical reminder can bring hope, healing, and peace to someone who is crying out. We pray that this prayer show and heart bring comfort to those who have received them. So please open our eyes so that we might see, open our ears so that we might hear, and open our minds so that we might know who is in need of your healing power. And please bless our prayer assured team when they make, when they buy, when they prepare for making these shorts, give them your peace, your love, your care. And use our ministry to bring and send your peace and love in the world. And this time we also pray for our brothers and sisters who need our prayers. They need your healing mercies. They need your strong hands. Please be with them and mend their wounds. And deliver them from their current situation. Heal them with your love and care. as a channel of the hope and peace. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And this is time for offering our gift and tithe. So I invite you to stand and we sing together.
Thank you.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Children of God, go into the world and bring the peace of God, and be peacemakers and do the ministry of reconciliation. God is with you and bless you today and tomorrow. Go in peace.